Stress doesn't just mess with your head, it can mess with your genes. A guy like me has got a million things to worry about. Unread emails, bosses, bills, wild ostrich attacks, machete juggling accidents. When we get worried, our bodies go through certain processes. Our heart rate increases, our digestion starts to shut down, our body begins to prepare to heal wounds. If you're going to commit to single combat with a robot assassin,
all systems ready.
This is great, but not every situation calls for feats of strength, so it's rather unfortunate that my body will react the same way, whether I'm trying to decide what to buy my wife for her birthday, or if I go to the bathroom and discover there's a polar bear there. Again. Chronic stress is a horrible long-term game plan. It can contribute to depression, to cardiovascular disease, it might even tamper with your genes. And not just turn certain genes on or off. Through epigenetic inheritance, you could pass these changes down to your children. So what I'm getting at is the future of humanity is at stake! Stop stressing out so much! Actually, easier said than done, right? Maybe not. Maybe stress is just an engineering problem. There's some evidence that simply looking at fractal patterns, like the ones in mountain crags and mangrove roots, can reduce your stress levels by up to 60%. Our brains seem to be hardwired to relax when we view these geometric patterns, whether in abstract art, urban landscapes, or office decor, not to mention digital displays. So, if we can imagine what a therapeutic fractal environment looks like, why not build it? Okay, so how about we engineer a little more meditation into our future? Research shows that some forms of meditation can reduce the stress hormone cortisol and slash stress levels in general. Or software could be an answer. Engineers have developed calm down apps that help tell you to relax and meditate a bit before going back to work. We could even automate this by hooking it up to some sort of galvanic skin conductance sensor that's in your mouse. But speaking about technology and stress, do you really need 2.9 billion results the next time you ask Google what's a good pizza joint near your neighborhood? Information overload is putting it lightly. It's more like an information black hole, and we're all getting sucked into it. That's why I like this idea of the semantic web, a real superhero when it comes to this sort of stuff. It's a machine-readable web. That means that the web itself knows what content is inside of it, so when you ask a question, it will come back with specific information relevant to your question and nothing else. So, does this mean that technology is actually adding stress, or that it's taking stress away? In the long run, I would say it's kind of a wash, but we always have one ace in the hole. It's called exercise. It worked in the past, it works in the present, and it'll work in the future. But I have a question for all of you. Do you think technology is making life more or less stressful? We want to know, so leave a comment and tell us. And make sure you like this video and subscribe to our channel, because we've got a lot more awesome shows about the future coming really soon.